knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
In this fourth tutorial on Agaricales, we will discuss still more families in this order. Specifically, we will be discussing Entolomataceae and Tricholomataceae, and the genera including Mycena, Omphalotus, and Marasmius. Let us begin with the family Entolomataceae, a large and structurally variable family consisting of gilled mushrooms that produce pink spores. Often you can notice the pink hue of the spores along the gills or lamellae of the mushroom. These spores have unique structures with distinct ridges and pits depending on the genus. All mushrooms in the family have gills that are attached to the stipe. Considering the family has over 1,500 unique species, identification requires collections of the mushrooms and analysis of the spore shape and cystidia types. Many species are saprobic, decomposing forest litter, soil, moss, or wood. Some species are mycoparasitic, meaning they will decompose other mushrooms. A notable mycoparasitic species in the family is Entoloma abortivum, commonly called shrimp of the woods. The mushroom has two structural forms, one with a cap, stipe, and gills, and then the aborted form, which is an irregular mass of hyphal tissue. This fungus is believed to parasitize armillaria species, or honey mushrooms, which we will discuss soon. Next, we will discuss the family Tricholomataceae. Classically, this family had been considered a wastebasket taxon, which refers to a taxon where scientists put species they cannot fit anywhere else. However, with modern developments in genetics, taxonomy within Tricholomataceae has become more legitimate. We will discuss one genus within this family, Tricholoma. Tricholoma is a large genus of mushrooms with gills attached to the stipe and white spore prints. They form ectomycorrhizal symbiotic relationships with a variety of trees. Tricholoma matsutake, commonly called matsutake or pine mushroom, is a luxurious ingredient in Japan. Mycorrhizal with Japanese red pine, matsutake is known for its intense, unique aroma and signifies the arrival of fall in Japan. Descriptions of the smell range from fruity and spicy to smelling like old socks. Kilograms of these mushrooms can be sold for hundreds of dollars. Unfortunately, the price will only increase with the mushroom now listed on the red list of threatened species. This decline in Japanese matsutake is due to the infection of Japanese red pine with the pinewood nematode, an invasive worm from North America. Although particularly famous in Asia, there is also an American matsutake found in abundance in the American Northwest, but also found in other northern parts of the United States and Canada. Moving on from the large and aromatic Tricholoma, let us now discuss the small and fragile genus Mycena. Mycena is a large genus of saprobic mushrooms with caps that are rarely larger than a centimeter in diameter. Often overlooked because of their small stature, once you stop and look at these mushrooms, you will begin to value their beauty. Mycena species have white spore prints with a conical-shaped cap and a thin, fragile stipe. Identification of species requires observation of the substrate the mushroom is decaying, as well as odor, color, liquid exuded when the mushroom is damaged, and stickiness or sliminess of the cap. Mycena species have a vast variability that will be rewarding when identifying species in nature. Mycena chlorophos is a bioluminescent species that glows greenish-white at night. The mushroom has been documented in Asia, Australia, and Brazil. Mycena hematopus, or the bleeding Mycena, is a maroon-colored mushroom that exudes a red fluid called latex when the mushroom is damaged, hence the name bleeding Mycena. This mushroom is saprobic and grows in clusters on woody debris along the forest floor. Both the mycelium and fruiting bodies have been reported to be bioluminescent. There are many other interesting Mycena species, so keep your eyes peeled for these small but grand discoveries. We will now discuss another small in size but captivating genus called Marasmius. Marasmius originates from the Greek word marasmos, meaning drying out. These saprobic mushrooms have a flat to somewhat convex cap. gills that produce a white spore print, and a durable central stipe. As the mushroom dries, the caps shrivel up, leaving a thin, dark stipe sticking out of leaf litter. Many Marasmius species are termed marcescent, meaning they can dry out and later be revived after rain. Most other mushrooms are termed putrescent, meaning they decompose with time. The type species of Marasmius is Marasmius rotula, commonly called the pinwheel mushroom. Marasmius rotula grows alone or in clusters of woody debris, and notably has gills attached to a collar that surrounds the blackish-brown stipe. Marasmius oreades, commonly called the fairy ring mushroom, is found in grassy fields and lawns. This mushroom can be larger than most other Marasmius species, with caps ranging from 2 to 5 centimeters in diameter. They are tan to brown colored and are known to form large fairy rings in the grassy areas they inhabit. They are commonly confused with other larger species, like the meadow mushroom, Agaricales campestris, and Chlorophyllum molybdites, mushrooms we discussed in the tutorial on Agaricaceae. Next, we will move on to two genera that are a part of the same family, Omphalotus and Lentinula. Mushrooms in the genus Omphalotus are saprobic, have a white spore print, and generally fruit in clusters at the base of tree trunks. A number of species within the genus have the common name jack-o'-lantern mushroom because of their bright orange color and bioluminescent properties. These mushrooms have gills that run down the stipe, and when fresh specimens are taken into a dark room, you will be able to see an eerie white glow emanating from the gills. These mushrooms should only be looked at and not eaten, as all mushrooms in the genus Omphalotus are considered poisonous. The genus Lentinula, although genetically similar to Omphalotus, houses one of the most common edible mushrooms, Lentinula edodes, or the shiitake mushroom. Shiitake is native to East Asia and is widely cultivated and consumed in China and Japan. Cultivation of these mushrooms generally requires wood logs to grow effectively. Logs have holes drilled into them, then pegs of shiitake mycelium grown in sawdust are placed in those holes. Over time, the mycelium fills the log and fresh shiitake mushrooms fruit from it. In Japan, shiitake mushrooms are served with miso soup and provide flavor in broths or stocks. In countries other than Japan, you can commonly find them dried and then rehydrated at home for recipes. Let's now move forward and learn still more about Agaricales.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.